Your move, sir. Oh, no, I've halved you.
Will it hurt at all?
Oh, I shouldn't worry about that, sir. I mean, take a tip from me. I've seen hundreds come and go. Let yourself go loose. I mean, he's an experienced man. He's a craftsman.
Yeah, but will it hurt at all?
Well, oh, it's rather like going to the dentist, sir. It's always worse in anticipation. But you'll have your little black bag over your head. You won't see any of the apparatus.
Little black bag?
Yes, you know, little black bag. They make them in Nottingham, sir. Oh, but I can't explain, sir. I'm no good with words at all. I can't tell you what goes on. You wait till the prison governor comes down. He'll set your mind at rest, sir.
Morning.
Lovely morning it is, too. There'll be rain before the day's out. 9 before 11, rain before 7, you know what they say.
So you'll be missing the rain, sir, won't you?
You know, I don't mind saying there's been an awful hoo-ha in Parliament about you. And so far as I can see, the Home Secretary doesn't like this business any more than you do. You know what parliamentary procedure is, and the case being sub judice and all that. Anyway, we'll see whether we can do anything about it afterwards. Nice seeing you, miss. You know, when I was at school, I was a bit of a lad. And whenever I used to get into a scrape, my headmaster used to say to me, "Now look here, I'll give you a choice. You can either be gated for a fortnight, or you can take 6 of the best and we'll forget all about it." Well, like any other self-respecting lad, I used to take 6 of the best. Well, what's the difference between this and capital punishment? You don't want to be cooped up for life, do you?
Yes, I do want to be cooped up for life.
Oh, come along, you're playing with words.
You don't want to go somewhere before you go, sir.